Hi, I've just come back from my last cosplay workshop at Auckland Libraries, and I made someone up as Elphaba using the actual products, which was awesome. I didn't think it would go on as easily on another person as it did on myself, so I'm very happy it did. It's a really good technique. It just feels like you're wearing foundation and a fair amount of powder, because the chroma cake dries powder into a powder which sits on top of your foundation, so it is very, very light. But I thought I'd try something a little bit different and work on my Ashara Zavros from Star Wars The Old Republic. So she's a Togruta with alien with horns and tentacles. I've got a picture of her on my screen at the moment to use as a guide because her makeup's a little bit different. So for this, I'm going to use a TV stick in white. This is 070. And I'm going to use some powder pigments that I've put into little colour pots. I've mixed these myself. I wouldn't use them on someone else except for a little bit of eyeshadow. But for this kind of work, you need you need to make your own custom colours. So they're a mixture of eyeshadows and blushes and a few pigment powders that I have used for makeup before as well. So the first thing I need to do is actually get my hair sorted, and it's partly why I've got this horrible little dinky style. And oh, I need to colour my hair because my roots are so pale, it looks like I don't have any at all. So I've got my hair basically to keep it as close around my hairline as possible, but because I'm going to wear the leku, I don't need to put the rest of my hair into little plaits as well. I actually need them way up here to help hold the headpiece in place. So a kabuki hair bun. This is all going under a latex bald cap, so it's a little bit weird, but that tiny bit of extra volume does help. It prevents the horns from sliding right back because they have a natural sort of sweep this way, which means that they like to hang off the back of your head, and this just helps prevent that from happening. It also helps the headpiece from pulling too much on the bald cap and pulling it away from your skin. I have not prepped my bald cap and my skin is not loving glue at the moment. It's kind of turning prosthetic aid into rubber at the moment, which is just bizarre. So hopefully this will work. Looks terrible. So the next thing I'm going to do is just dry my face a little bit. And this is where you can see I'm definitely wearing no makeup because my skin has gone bright red. But if I can this is essentially an exfoliation for my skin type. And it basically acts to absorb that. So I'm going to also use a very little bit of powder just to blot and dry a little. So this is a cheapy bald cap you can get at any store at Halloween, unless you actually ask for it, because these have not been available for a year or more. Wow, this is a lot tighter fit than my previous lot, so woohoo! And I'm using the camera as a mirror, and I don't actually have it mirrored, so this is going to be a bit interesting. So the next thing to do is to get prosthetic aid, and I have it in a little travel bottle, and I'm going to just use I'll use the top of that because I can clean it. So I have a little dish down here that I am putting my glue onto to help transfer it to my face, and I'm going to choose a different brush to put it on. There it is. I've already used this, so it's a bit gummed up. So the next step is to just, my hairline is about here with the little tiny sticky up here, so I'm going to try and just go along the inside. And I'm stippling because this is very difficult to do in reverse. And I am going all the way down to there. My headpiece sits right here, which is very frustrating, but that's what Tagrutta do. They basically have a 16th century hairline for where the prosthetics go. So this is all on before doing any kind of priming work, otherwise you can wind up with the glue sticking to your foundation or primer and then not to your skin. So I'm just going to have to pretend that's not as uneven as it is. So this side you can now see is a bit glossy. That's tacky to the surface, to the touch. So I'm just going to do a little bit more. Oh, that's very strange. I'm not actually having a mirror proper. Okay, that is now grabbing my skin. I do have a little sponge, so I can always use the edge for a more. There we go. Right, that's just for a slightly wider application. So now I'm just going to bring the bald cap forward a little and find this one that matches. And because I don't really have to do the sides because it's covered by the hip piece, that's not such a big issue with it rolling up at the back there. So I will now hair pin the back. Rather than glue it at this stage, because the weight of the headpiece will hold the latex and the bald cap in place. That's going to be really annoying, isn't it? I'm going to show throughout the entire video. So I'll, again, because this part of the face is not seen, I'm going to completely miss the bald cap. Because I cannot see what I'm doing. Okay, fold it under and hairpin this way. This is the thing about latex, it's very springy. However, that looks better, so. And I'll have another little pin. Yes, I do. Yay. So that's the ball cap just staying in place to basically hide the hairline here. What I would normally do at this stage is to use some more of the prosthetic aid with a bit of capsil, which is fumed silica, but I am really health conscious at the moment when it comes to any powders or fumes or anything, because I'm not the only person in my family who's having problems at the moment with chemicals. So I'm very concerned that overexposure to a lot of product right now is not a, is a really silly idea. So I'm going to try extra setting powder instead, because in theory that should make a little paste. But it's basically to hide this line. Unfortunately, my setting powder has a very good series of holes in the sprinkle system, so it doesn't actually want to release a lot of powder. This is really awkward. Why did I think it was a good idea to not use a mirror? I have a small mirror, so I'm going to use that instead of the camera. This is, oh, very stuck, very well stuck. Okay. It's just slightly uneven when I see it in the mirror. So, yeah. So this layer of glue helps disguise the seam at the same time as being an extra layer of glue to hold the bald cap down. And I forgot to mention, yes, I am wearing contact lenses. They're very obvious, especially when you don't have any makeup on at all. I regularly wear contact lenses anyway, so I'm once again not going to make suggestions. That's a health and safety issue. But if you do want to wear contacts, go see an optician. Do not buy contact lenses from anyone that doesn't give you a fitting. And only a licensed optometrist will actually fit your eyes. I happen to be very lucky that my base curve is a standard 8.6. I was checked over and they said I was 8.7, but when I wear 8.7, the lens pops off my eye. So I suspect that my eyeball shape is actually slightly somewhere between the two. This is just a little stipple effect with a sponge to again help disguise that. The glue is white when it's still wet and dries clear, so it's kind of handy for seeing where you have been. And where you've got your, where it's still too wet to put anything on. So while that's drying, I'm going to start with my face. Yeah, it's not too bad actually. So I'm going to use my TV stick. This is fantastic. You can probably see I'm very pale, but also very pink. So for me to wear foundation, you wind up using, it winds up being very opaque. I can't use a tinted moisturizer. It just looks like I've got like a tea stain or my freckles which I have a lot of, have gone out of control. So it's not very flattering. So what I use instead of most foundations is this in 01 Rose, and you might be able to see the container has a pearly effect. That's an interference red. The liquid itself is very translucent, but does have a light reflecting properties. So that's why I can wear just that for Elsa and nothing else. I'm gonna use my beauty sponge. I do love this, especially for when you want to avoid a particular area. And I have given all my brushes a thorough wash and clean last night to be able to have enough brushes for myself. And my lovely volunteer Ali, I can't quite remember how to pronounce it, but I remember she's got the name of one of the Glinders. So I had enough brushes to alphabify her, and I've got enough for myself today as well. Yes, Ashara is a full body paint technically, but I'm going to try and only do a small amount and see if I can throw something on to hide too much neck. So this is basically my primer foundation in one. I use a very, very, very light powder. In fact, what I will usually use is just a puff. Oops. And only removes excess moisture, except for where I use eyeshadow or blush, and then I'll use a tiny bit of setting powder underneath that just so it doesn't move. But otherwise, I find in photography this reacts better than doing full face makeup, until I found this, because this is very, very, very soft and sticks and does not look either greasy or cakey or waxy or anything like that. However, this is the first time I've used it all over my face, so this is a learning curve for me as well. There's too much brown on that, but otherwise a small round goat here. It's probably the most ideal brush, but I also have foundation brush, so I'm going to see how that works. Actually, it's not too bad. I kind of like that. The TV stick, you can see the green, is used for TV, even high def, and I was very skeptical because I thought it's a really waxy product, but it does in fact stick really nicely. So this is white, and so that's what I mean when I say I'm pale. This with a tiny bit of pigment is going to work less as like a clown white and more as a mattifying all-in-one base colour. So yes, that is now dry. And one of the things you might see is there is still an edge. That's because I have not filled that in properly. But there's also some hair under there, and some glue from overkill. So I'm just going to ignore it and pretend it's not there, because it's not as bad as it feels. So I'm basically using the TV stick just like a foundation at this stage. And the reason being, I'm using basically straight up pigment powder on top of this to create my colour. And Ashara luckily has her eyebrows pretty much where they are on people, so quite often for this kind of makeup, for example, for Darth Talon, I would wax or fill with wax, not wax, or glue stick my eyebrows flat, but they're going to be basically a really good guide for her dark shadow anyway. So this, I'm going to be getting this in my skin tone so that I can use it essentially as a gigantic concealer. I could apply this directly to my face for a much heavier layer, but I don't really want to waste it. Keep your brush out of your eyes, so this is as close to my eyelids as I'll go. Well, my lower lid, the rim of the eye, because I don't want anything accidentally transferred. There's more glue there, fantastic. I have a few foundation brushes because one of the things with body paint is sometimes your brush will stain. So this is for Darth Talon only, or later when I actually have her finished, and I just bought some foam today to try and get it finished. When I do Ahsoka, I'll need that red one because that's at least reasonably in keeping with the orange tones for her. This really is the first time I've done more than just a back of the hand test. So I haven't yet had to figure out how to avoid streaks off. This brush is basically putting it on, but I'm going to use another brush to smooth it out in a sec. Although, okay, that's not too bad. The underside is flattened out a bit, so much better, but I will see how my other brush is. I still haven't pushed this up any further, and there's heaps left, so this is a very good investment for $40 New Zealand. I have a feeling this will last for quite a while. I've already given away basically about $7 worth, so it really is going to last a very long time. So my next step is to use a slightly softer brush. Let's see if I can still one of the things with doing an opaque, that looks so messy, it's not as bad as it looks. This kind of paint is, you can see the brush sometimes lifts it off my skin. So you do use a very gentle flicking motion. You can see that's buffing and blending. And that's one of the reasons why the TV stick in Elphaba Green 511, That's the super color. You can see why it's used on stage, because it does blend and soften really well while being very durable. Okay. These goat hair brushes are very similar to what is used for Elphaba, except they use a much wider, thicker brush. So that's going to be a little bit more tricky up here, and I might have to use a concealer type brush, which I do still have, thank goodness. Minutes so far. This would be the full Elphaba time frame if I was to do Elfie. So at this stage the wax and the paint is still very soft. Is why I can use such a soft brush to transfer it. Patience really is the key. So I've got a little bit missing on the bridge of my nose, which I'll just tidy up. So puffing up my cheeks to help blend into all the pores. Sorry, that's what I was doing there. So if you were doing an armadillo makeup, this would probably be a really good base. Sorry, just keep taking it off my lips because it is disconcerting otherwise. So the next step is setting powder. And for stage, you normally just go with a great big huge mop brush and powder puff. I don't really need to use that much. And yes, this is a stipple brush or a airbrush. I have two. I have this long handled one for at home, and then I have one that I've taken off brush handle to take with me to conventions and have it in my little kit, so that it doesn't take up too much room, because with makeup like this you do need to keep touching it up. So this is also a really good base for Asajj Ventress, who just, you know, happens to be the opposite of Ahsoka, so that's kind of fun. So that's just checking to see how well that's worked. That's the base white, and I haven't done this properly because I'm not entirely sure where my headpiece will sit. So the next step is to paint Ashara's colours. Now she's got some very interesting markings, which might be a bit overkill for me trying to do today. So again, I'm going to have to use my little mirror and mark out a guide, and I'm going to use a little bit of these are eye drops. I use that to apply eyeliner quite often because it's sterilized and my powders are set using alcohol, so that's sterilized. So it just minimizes any kind of risk of infection and avoids the whole issue of alcohol near your eyes, which is the kind of stuff I normally do. Okay, Ashara has some really strange stuff going on here. Oh, this is the customization four, which you can pick up from the Kib, I think it is, or Ilum. She's got the crimson leku, so, gosh. Oh, seriously, I don't know what I'm doing. I should have planned slightly more. I would actually highly recommend using a stencil for this kind of work. However, I was silly enough to start the process this way, so I'm going to have to keep going this way. And because I seem to have misplaced a few of my concealer brushes, which are essentially flat rounds, but made from they're synthetic fibers, but they're quite dense. So, oh, what am I doing? We'll start with her eyes. So this is essentially using eyeshadow. Mm-hmm. As a paint. Or pure pigment as a paint. And this is why you do use setting powder, so that you've got the ability to be able to blend. Ashara appears to have mainly shadow going on around her brows. So I'm using a base of dark purple before I use a heavy black, because it just helps lift the color and not make it look so painted on. I'm using the purple as a mixture of contour and color. Wisest to whisper in front of the camera because it was not going to pick it up. There is weird stuff going on with her eyes. It's not quite a simple makeup. And my Ashara headpiece is not fully finished. I've only colour blocked it, which means I need to shade it and weather it to help sell it as an actual appendage rather than a hat stuck on. Thank you. It's a little black swan looking. I'm wondering if that was one of the influences, but you know. So the next thing to do, actually, I'm grabbing the already coloured one, and I'm going to have to use more eye drop. I didn't realise when I pressed my powder pot just how well I had pressed it. It's almost impossible to take the coating off, so I'm going to have to really, there we go. Hopefully that's working. I don't have any alcohol out, and I don't fancy putting peroxide on this, which is the only other product I have within reach. This is just another little powder puff. So that's the guideline for where I don't want to colour in. Hopefully this will actually work there. Unfortunately, having quite a bit of trouble with this colour pot. I'm not sure why. I think there just may be a layer of glitter on there, which is not supposed to be there. Much more the colour that I want, which is awesome. So I basically do just need a liquid. So I'm just gonna keep using droplets. So because I'm using a clear liquid with powder, this is working a little bit like a watercolor on the work over a solid base. So as I'm brushing, I'm both laying down the purple and picking up the white, which is why I'm using the edge to define the edges, because it lays down more color than it picks up. So hopefully that's reasonably obvious and easy to follow. Kryolan also does a lilac face paint, but this way I can do the white base and color the purple over the top rather than try and do a purple base and put white over the top, because as you can see, it is picking up a lot of color. And if you were to try and do it the other way around, you could easily lift up and wind up with a very purple area where you want the white. There we go, that's why. Right. I'm just going to cheat the line down a little, because it's her little pointy bit goes right into the corner of the nose, and having managed to overpaint one side, I'm going to have to do the other. So feel free to keep forwarding through the thumbnails as this goes on. Again, and wait for that to dry, then put a layer of white over the mistakes. So a little bit more liquid. I can make that really tidy. Face to do. This is a frustrating trying to even each side up. Again, because I'm not using the mirror effect on my camera, it can be a bit disconcerting as to what side I'm working on. So, back to this side. So that's not. So it's not perfect. This is good practice for when I do actually need to completely paint myself up. My initial time frame was for next weekend, but that's kind of gone. I don't need to, which is good. The reason for doing this paint of straight up pigment powder, you can see it's wet on the surface because I've been using liquid, is because the TV stick acts as a foundation and concealer in one go, and it really does mix in really well with paint, just any pigment color. And that's fantastic because it means I don't have to try and find two colors that work together. Also, I know how my skin reacts to the one color stick, and any pigment over the top of that is essentially then part of that colour, that paint system, rather than being an additional paint over the top. Oh wow, yeah, that's needs blending. So if you find yourself in a similar kind of situation with sensitive skin that doesn't like many products at all, you can use one product as your support and then just colour over with pigment powders that you've you can just buy highly pigmented colour, eyeshadow colour, or I think places like Kryolan do sell pots of pressed pigment, and that way you're pretty guaranteed to not have a reaction unless you're allergic to a particular mineral pigment. My nose always runs when I do face paint, so it's not a big issue if that is the case for you. However, I'm going to use a different cloth, which will be washed, to wipe up the nose. So the next thing is I've got to put some dark line on. I'm going to keep evening that up and contouring. I have this fantastic brush for if the powder is really resistant. And it just says powder brush. It's a little elf brush. It's kind of like a flat top kabuki. And because this is a water-based powder, as well as being a powder. It works really well, and a bit like a powder puff, just a little bit more, a little bit softer. So blends just a little bit more. And I can blend the powder straight onto my skin. So tools and the right color base. So my camera is on a slightly strange angle, so it's making everything look slightly off. I do my makeup very much the same way I do my costumes. I try and use the appropriate product for the appropriate purpose, because I am often, I often wind up at a convention and just with no one to help me. So things need to be done, able to be done by me. So the next one is, I'm going to see if I can do the lips. I do have a colour stain, which should work. See, different lip, different cloth. I like these colour stains because they go over and under everything. And they actually just do as they say, they're a stain rather than a full-on lip. Which means you can use them to define your natural lip and then do an obvious lipstick over. That's kind of fun. For Ashara, she also has a slightly pouty lip, so I'm going to do a little bit of a lip, a lip liner, if I can. I don't have a pencil sharpener, unfortunately. Again, for lips, I prefer using lip products, just as I prefer using actual eyeliner around my eyes rather than one of these colour pops that I've created. So the next step is to do exactly what I said I'm not going to do. Ashara's pink lips, and then she has a little strip of white to match the stripe down there. But I'm running out of time, so I should do my eyes as per the image. Of course I find that now. So I'm going to use another round and my angled brush. There we go, that's the one I want. And once again, I'm going to have to use my little side mirror. Sorry, this camera is slightly off-center. I think I might have put the wrong settings on initially. So, oh, help. So this is where the initial black swan shape comes into play. Could break out my eyeliner because I do prefer to use it, but I'm a bit worried that it'll move the grease stick underneath. So it's very hard to see what's going on with her makeup, to be honest. Aside from one thing in a bit, there we go. Now we try and match up again. Again, little colour pop. And it's essentially just a whole lot of black eyeshadow crushed together and pressed with isopropyl alcohol and really pressed down to basically be a pot that'll last me for as long as it will need to. So I'm going to attempt to tidy this area up. Which may or may not work. There's something very strange going on with my camera. So, try. Working. So finally, my TV stick, which is grey and invisible. Actually, that's a bit silly. So I'm going to use my clean contouring stick, contouring concealer brush. And tidy up some of the white. Looking a lot better. Before I mess this up too much, I'm going to set it all again. So once again, powder. Tidy my away, and this time I'm going to use a very big, not that one, because that was the one I used on Alfie. So, it looks like I used a number actually. So I will use this bronzing brush. Again. Sorry. Thank you. now, yay, that's nearly all done. I get to do a little bit of contouring because at a distance my nose kind of disappears. So I'm using the dark purple. Create shadows where there weren't any before. This has already been used on some bronzer already, so I'm going to use that to define my jaw and cheekbones a bit. One of the problems with a lot of face paint is it's very easy to lose depth and contour using just a single color. So for Elfie, they use purple for her blush and a little bit of mid-tone shaping, and a lovely olive bronze duotone shimmer. So for this, I'm using a much pinker purple. Just continue to buff it in. And the reason for I love this technique is it's essentially one paint with colors put on top. It's very similar to the chroma cake effect, except instead of having a pre-made compact, you can use your eyeshadow, your bronzing powder, anything else you already know your skin reacts to well, you can use that. So having now done this, you can also do a very soft color. You don't have to do a full-on paint. You can just use essentially a kabuki brush straight onto a primer for a very translucent color. And I'm basically doing that for my neck simply because I don't have the time to do my entire hands and neckline and even around the back. But I did want to actually put on my Ashara tentacles, so they're very, very, very unfinished. However, they do work. Oh, look at that lovely inside. Okay. And sorry, she's stuck on the chair. It's Something's happened. It's not even... I need to my mirror. Excuse me for one sec. This is not working. Oh dear. Aha. That's where she's not working. Right, so this is Ashara Zavros. And you can see I don't actually have a huge amount of hairline showing. And now that I've actually got them on, I could colour in a little further through here. But for the purposes of an internet tutorial, I think this is enough. So, Ashara Zavros. And this does sit in place very nicely and easily. There we go. I would, if I was to wear this for a proper event, I would be tidier with my hairline, and I would possibly sit her further back. So, la la. The full effect. So that is random cat in the background, of course. I'm a cosplayer, costumer. Cat. He doesn't care. So, he's a honey badger. So this is, I'll see if I can show a little bit more of the liku. My liku are very wiggly. As you can see, they actually curve and dance with me. Look in the back. So I have a few things I want to fix. Part of this is foreshortening because this camera is very close. But I'd like to get the horns to stay upright a little bit more. Anyway, these are based on the Shakti mound trial that I made years ago. So I didn't create a new mold. I am creating a new mold for Ahsoka. I'm doing the Rebels version. And I'll be using the same paint technique for her, so... But I love this Ashara customization. So, I'm going to take these off and wash my face. Oh, for face washing, I'm going to slather on my normal moisturizer, then wipe that off with a dry face cloth, and then if there's anything stuck in my hair or like around in my nose, I'll use a little bit of isopropyl myristate. And then wipe that off and then use a cleanser. I find moisturizer is very gentle, and it's a product that my skin is already familiar with, so I don't have to worry about reactions. So, la la la. And my Ashara is in the speed suit, just like my Jedi Knight. So I will be making that costume. So sadly, this is not a customization look you can use for your playable characters, but Ashara has it, so yay. I might actually reshape lips for next time I do this, so bye, hopefully.